I love being back in D.C. I lived here for a while. I love it here, man. Oh, thanks a lot. That's real nice. I live in New York City right now. I got an apartment. It's a little bigger than my body. And my friend came over to give me advice. He's like, you got to get nice little hand soap for your bathroom. Women love that. And I was like, do they also love it when your shower's 1 foot from your toaster? Because I got that going on too. I saw a mouse in my apartment the other day. I leaned over, I was like, where are you gonna sleep? I got a great building though. I got my own drug dealer for the building. So every time I walk out my door, the same guy tries to sell me drugs. So, like, I'm walking out in the morning to get a Snapple. And this guy will be like, you want weed? You want smoke? And I'm like, do you have any Snapple? Because I think he should also sell Snapple. That way he hooks you in with the Snapple. And then he's like, you know, it'd go great with that Snapple. Crack. It'd be like Amazon.com. If you like Snapple, you might also enjoy balloons of heroin. And I'd be like, I never thought of it that way. But yeah. I'm not big into drugs. I don't smoke a lot of pot anymore, even, because I'm the least fun person to smoke pot with. No one wants to hang with the guy who ends every sentence with, do you guys hate me? Yeah, I'm not good at drinking either. My friends will drink anywhere. My friends actually drink at the laundromat, and then I tried it, and I thought I was in a submarine navigating the sea of dirty panties with my Spanish-speaking crew. I was like, Mrs. Sanchez, set the coordinates to permanent press. Rita, the engines are stalling. Get me some quarters and another drink. This place is starting to look like a laundromat. There's all these sports analogies when you drink. Pre-game, party foul. I have to make up my own. The other day I was like, oh, I pulled a hamstring. Everyone was like, what does that mean? It's like, I threw up on your couch. Then I did it again, I was like, 30 love. See, I can't drink too much. I become another person. Like, last year I went out drinking, and I met this girl, and she gave me her number. Next day, I didn't even want to call her, because I didn't feel like she met me. Like, I felt like she met Two Drink Mike. Like, Two Drink Mike loves dancing and knows a magic trick. Zero Drink Mike enjoys biographies and has serious opinions about wildlife. Five Drink Mike enjoys dancing with wildlife. I am, actually. I got this card in the subway this week that says lose 10 to 400 pounds. I'm pretty sure I don't want to lose the whole 400, because then I'd weigh negative 235, and that seems like a dangerous weight, you know? But I make deals with myself. I'm like, I can eat this cheeseburger, but then later I'm going to the gym. And instead of going to the gym, I eat a cake. I'm like, the deal is off. My other weakness is sugar cereal. Like, if I buy a box of Cinnamon Toast Crunch at 3 in the afternoon, that box ain't making it to 10 a.m. Because it's like crack, you know? Like, you don't buy crack for some point in the future. You buy it when you want it, and then you fall asleep in the tub. Or whatever. See you around the building. I know, and I don't have like a weight problem, but I am like the guy who could really put the brakes on an orgy. Like everyone would be like, was he invited? Why is he eating a cake? I've never been in an orgy, but I feel like it'd be like what happens when I try and play pickup basketball. Like, no one passes me the ball. Everyone asks me to keep my shirt on. I try and go to the gym. The idea is to impress women, but it seems counterproductive because there are women at the gym and they can see me bench pressing 65 pounds. And I don't think they're saying, check out the guy in the dress socks. I saw him do one chin up and then fall on the ground. That is hot. I went to a class at my gym called water aerobics, which was basically 15 gay men and me in a pool playing splash.